So, grazie Tomasini, and I am the coordinator of Make It Be project, decision making and implementation tool for delivery of local and regional bioenergy chains. Well, I will give you a very short brief overview of the partnership first, and I take occasion to thank all partners working together in this project. So CRPV is a company for which I'm working and is a leader of the project, as you know, is based in Italy, and in particular in Emilia-Romagna region. Then ICLEI, local government for sustainability, placed in Germany. And then Island Birchwood, who is Scottish, and then the Italian Thermotechnical Committee, based in Milan, in Italy, and again the European Center for Renewable Energy, based in Giessen, Austria, and again the European Landowner Organization, ELO, that I thanks very much for helping us to organize this event, and again the Slovenian Forest Service, based in Slovenia, of course, and Centuria RIT is Romagna Technology Innovation, based in Emilia-Romagna too, so in Italy as well. Well, this is very roughly, I will give you a brief description of the structure of our project and what means the linkage in between the different parts that composed our project. At the beginning of our project, good practices in integrated bioenergy planning were assessed and evaluated and identified, and that activity was led by ELO, and all partners were involved on that, and I thank also Georgia, who is present as ICLEI representatives, who helped strongly on this on these topics in particular. Well, these good practices, in our opinion, were important in order to have some good example to know and to take care about, in order to have some reference based on which to develop better our activity. That was first based on the establishment of a network in each region involved, and in particular four regions were involved, Italy, Emilia-Romagna region, and the regional leader is Centuria RIT, another region is Slovenia, another one is the islands in Scotland, and the fourth one is Burgenland in Austria. Well, in each of these four regions, a network with the key actors and main stakeholders and mostly local authorities were set up and developed. That was a very important part of the projects, not without difficulties, I have to anticipate. However, very important to have a good linkage with the structure, with the territory in which we were working, developing our activity. On the same, at the same time, a methodology has been carried out, well, developed, I would say, and defined in order to support bioenergy initiatives. And the leader of this activity has been the Thermotechnical Committee, and Professor Riva, who will talk after and will show us our methodology. Then, as the last step, but not less important, I would say one of the most important one, is the implementation of bioenergy initiatives in the four regions involved in the projects. So all regional leaders were very strongly involved together with the network established in each of these regions in order to evaluate what kind of biomass, potential biomass was available, energy demand, and so on, in order to achieve at the end what we called agenda. Agenda, which is, I will tell you after, a kind of scenario for bioenergy planning in the specific territory based on real perspective and restrictions. It promotes the way for the development or expansion of bioenergy supply chain and stimulating, of course, the interaction among them. Well, of course, all the activities carried out, developed, and set up along the project were widely disseminated at regional, national level. And thanks to our two international partners, so ICLEI and ELO, we had also an international disseminations of the project results. Well, these are the main results of our projects. We will go to show them, some of them, related to the good practices. As our project officer already mentioned this morning, we prepared a kind of report on them, and it's available on our website, but some copies are still left outside if somebody would be interested in it. Well, I think that I already said these main points. I mean, the establishment of this network at regional level that we called Regional Bioenergy Partnership, and then the tools or methodology that we developed for bioenergy planning, its application, and of course the definition of bioenergy agenda, at least one for each region. Now I will stop, and I will give directly the word to Professor Riva, who will show us our methodology.
Thank you, Maria Grazia, our coordinator, and also our chairman today. Thank you. And the scope of my presentation is I have to understand, pitch down, okay. The scope is to present the results we obtained in working package 4 of a MIB project, Make It Be project. And this package was devoted to the development of supporting tools for bioenergy initiatives. And we have developed the tools that I will try to explain in few words in the next minutes, and we had a common work on these tools. We have discussed them, and we have adjusted them for our specific goals. So, why a methodology? The basic problem we find when we propose a new initiative in the field of biomass, sometimes, or very often, I can say, is to understand and to speak with not experts, to understand the energy balance of a certain area, so how much energy is used, and especially for the final user points, typically residential sector, transports, and so on, and how much biomass we need to cover partially or totally these energy consumption or needs. We need also to understand which type of biomass we can use, and in other terms, how much land we need to produce biomass, to cover needs, and so on. The main problem is that we have to speak with stakeholders, and as I mentioned to you, stakeholders are not so expert, typically a mayor. If you want to organize, or if you want to propose, for instance, a small district plant, you haven't to convince experts. You have to convince the mayor. And he wants to understand how much energy we want to produce, how much biomass we need, and so on. And or it is the same, the contrary. If we have some biomass, if we have some land, how much energy we can get from these resources, land and or biomass. Keeping this in mind, we have prepared the proposal for MIB, and we have included many steps for to develop a specialized methodology. And in the previous session, you have seen a very sophisticated tool that is available on the web. We have prepared a simplified method because we are thinking not to the specialist, but we are thinking to the decision makers that are not specialists, but they want to understand the matter. In this slide, you can see the formal words we have used in the proposal and in the project. From a practical point of view, our methodology is formed by five main steps. The first step is to make an energy analysis of a certain area, because it is important to understand how much energy is used, and for instance, for houses, for transport, for industry, and so on. The second step regards the estimation of the biomass availability in the same area, so how much biomass we can have from. Not the theoretical biomass, but the net potential, so taking into account all the other uses and also the environmental restrictions. So for instance, if we have theoretically 5 tons per hectare of straw, I can't use 5 tons. Perhaps I can use 2-3 tons, depends on many things. So all these aspects have to be taken in account. The third step is a detailed assessment and mapping of the resource, of the biomass, and we have seen many examples today. Our philosophy was to choose, as I mentioned before, simplified tools. And so detailed assessment and mapping of the biomass, the definition of the possible bioenergy chains that could be used in the specific context, to rank, so to make a ranking of the bioenergy chains, because one could be more feasible, another one could be less feasible, and so on. And the definition of an action plan or agenda that we have defined in this project agenda. And the last step is the implementation and monitoring of activity. So 5 steps. For these 5 steps, we have developed 2 tools, 1 tool for the biomass, for the energy analysis, a second tool for the estimation of the net potential of biomass, so biomass availability, real availability, and we have developed a guideline for the three last steps. So 2 tools and a guideline. So questions. What have you done? What have you at the end of the project? We make available 2 tools. I repeat, one tool for energy balances, a second tool for biomass potential estimations. They are practically two Excel files. The second one is also available on the web. And a guideline for the less analytical phases of our methodology. Are these products available? Yes, they are available on the web. You can download them. It is possible to apply them in other parts. Yes, we think so. Please try, download, try to apply them. It is a material fully available without password, without any kind of problems. We have produced also a toolkit for training, because we have performed, I don't know if we speak about this point later during our, no. Okay, we have performed some training courses along the project. We have produced this toolkit, practically a CD-ROM, in which we have the two tools, the guidelines, and also some examples. So, this methodology is useful for what, for whom? At the end, after having using it and collecting all the comments we have, we can say that it is useful for to anyone who, without a specific background, wants to understand the potential role of a biomass in a specific area. That means for a first assessment of the potential of a biomass in specific areas, or to address stakeholders and interest groups, or to address institutions and so on. It is obviously less useful, so advantages and disadvantages, less useful for experts and designers, or when good data are available. In some cases, good data have been collected in the past. It is possible to find this kind of situation. It has been spent a lot of money on biomass, so we can find also traces of this money somewhere. In conclusion, the methodology provides the best results when used for the initial planning of the energy use of the biomass. From this point of view, we think to have fulfilled our initial objectives. So, to have something useful for non-experts. Some details about some steps. The first step, energy balance. The tool we are providing is something that assists the user to use, for instance, the energy units. Energy units are something that not easy to use, even also for experts. This tool assists you to use the different units and assist the user to make some order between the sources, energy sources, and the final sectors that use energy, like industry, transport, the residential sector, public services, and agriculture. And gives some graphics that are useful to understand the numbers, to better understand the numbers. The tool for the estimation of the biomass availability apply this philosophy that I tried to explain in two words at the beginning of this presentation. So, generally speaking, we have a biomass potential that could be represented by the rectangle that you see, the external rectangle or that you see on this slide. And you have to consider environmental restriction, current competing uses, also technical losses. And generally speaking, only a small part is available for energy conversion. We have translated this concept in relationships, different relationships for agricultural residues, for livestock wastes, for forestry residues, and co-products from industry, especially from agro-industry, and also co-products from the civil sectors, like municipal wastes. We have also considered municipal wastes because, as you know, municipal wastes are an important source of biomass. In average, the 50% of the energy content of these materials is renewable. In the tool, it is possible to put some data. Some data are already defined, and at the end, defining also the chain, that means the initial biomass, the type of a biofuel that we need, and the type of energy that we want, that means or fuel for transport or electricity or thermal energy, it is possible to have an idea regarding the energy that we can harvest, we can say, from the fields or from the forests. The other part of the methodology are, as I told you before, are less analytical. So we give some direction to use GIS software, but I want to say software that is available on internet as freeware. And we give some directions for the ranking of the biomass energy chains and for the planning and evaluation of the same chains. So how to manage complex concepts like or complex matter like the efficiency of the conversion of the energy. So we give some information about the technology, about the greenhouse gases, the production of greenhouse gases, and other technical factors. And for the monitoring, we suggest some checklists that make possible to produce some evaluation on the same chains. Thank you. Simple methodology, but available, really available, and simple presentation.
Thank you very much for the clear presentation and short one as well. Now I ask to Mr. Joachim Hacker to start with our second presentation that is related to the activity carried out within each region involved in the projects. And after him, the other regional leader will follow in order to present their results on the specific territories based on the methodology application and all the necessary input and relationship with the regional bioenergy partnership or network, if you prefer, and calculation done. Sorry, Joaquin, I close here and I open your. Oh, maybe it's not at the beginning.
Okay, thank you, Maria Grazia. Ladies and gentlemen, good afternoon also from my side. My name is Joachim Hacker. I'm representing the European Center for Renewable Energy in Güssing. Only a few words maybe to our organization. In Austria, we are a private organization and dealing since more than 15 years with different kind of renewable energies, especially in the town of Güssing, especially in our region in the south of Burgenland, and trying now to transfer our experiences from the last years to other regions, to other countries, and giving a kind of know-how transfer also within different kind of EU projects, but also trying to foster our initiatives in the land of Burgenland, which has also been part of the Make It Be project. I will give you now an overview about the work packages which are directly linked to the regional actions, as well as with the actions itself in our region in Austria, followed afterwards by the other project regions in Scotland, in Slovenia, as well as in Italy. And yeah, starting now with the overview of our work package 5, the assessment of regional bioenergy situation and identification of potential bioenergy change. What do we mean with this? We have more or less three main work packages which are linked with the initiative of work package 5. So the methodology, we've heard it before, is a main thing of Make It Be project itself. So we have tried to produce a kind of methodology, a kind of guideline for the regions to have or to be able to harmonize the approaches and to do different assessments which have been on the plan within Work Package 5. So within Work Package 5 we had to start with the implementation of implementation of the methodology and different actions, regional actions, and all those things are in close connection with the regional bioenergy partnership. So it is crucial for the establishment of bioenergy chains to have stakeholders involved, to involve them not at the end of the project but at the beginning. We have seen this many times in our region, that if stakeholders are not involved, if decision makers are not involved, it could be quite difficult to implement at the end of the day the project. The work package 5 itself consists of different parts. So we are going to apply the methodology, first of all trying to describe and analyze the current bioenergy situation, to assess biomass potential, to assess the energy demand, as well to identify different new bioenergy chains, and at the end, and this is one of the most important thing, to create a kind of agenda, to create a kind of strategy, a kind of action plan for each region on different time frames, and if possible for maybe the next 3, 5, or 10 years. So to have an idea what can be done within the next years, what can be the next steps, and how can we try to get into self-sufficiency at the end of the day. As described in the application form, we have concrete results within Work Package 5, so 4 regional reports on potential bioenergy initiatives, including intermediate results of bioenergy planning process, as well as the regional agendas. So in each region, in each project region, we are or have tried to produce different reports on assessed data, as well as the regional agendas. That's more or less the main parts and tasks of our work package 5. And now I want to go on with our concrete results to these tasks in Austria. In Austria itself, we have the project region Burgenland. It's in the southeast of Austria. It's quite small in comparison maybe to other provinces in Europe, or to other provinces also within the project. We are speaking about 300,000 inhabitants and 4,000 square kilometers. As a reason of, due to the fact that we have, or the southeast of Burgenland is one of the poorest regions in Austria, has been one of the poorest regions in Austria. We already have started a long time before with different actions on renewables in the south of Burgenland, so especially in the town of Güssing, and established many different projects on renewable energies and trying now to foster these experiences also to other regions in Burgenland, and therefore we've chosen within Make It Be the land of Burgenland. As already mentioned before, regional bioenergy partnerships are essential, and therefore one of our first steps had been the establishment of such an regional bioenergy partnership. The partnership should be the link, if possible, between the methodology of the project, between the bioenergy chains, as well as at the end of the project for the bioenergy agenda. So it has a discussion through the overall project with the RBP, a discussion on the methodology, a discussion on the different bioenergy change we have identified, as well as at the end also a discussion on the bioenergy agenda itself. And we've also tried to harmonize this agenda with still existing strategies to be in line with other projects. In our region itself, we have tried to set it up in the way that we have made one core group, so one decision-making core group, as well as some external groups. So we have tried to focus on an additional group, the energy strategy team, on regional network groups, so that we have as well the regional level, the provincial level, and the national level included into the overall process. And we think that it is quite important to have different kind of institutions involved, and also different levels, so regional, provincial, as well as national. And the representatives are more or less national, regional decision makers, land managers, suppliers, energy plant installers, and as well external experts. Here's only a graphic for the structure. So we have the core group, as well as external groups and external experts, which are going to discuss different processes of the project and giving their feedback to the management group, so to our institution at the end of the day. One of our first tasks within the assessments was to identify, or to get an overview about the current situation, so to see what is already installed, what is the situation now. Therefore, we also identified still existing plants. We try to get data of still existing plants, which is very important for the agenda afterwards, as well as for the planning of new plants. So to get to know what is already installed, where biomass resources are already being used. And therefore we had the identification of different bioenergy plants. As you can see, especially in the south of Burgenland, a lot of different district heating plants as well as CHP plants are already installed, and this is also due to the fact that we have already started since 15 years ago with these initiatives, which is not built up here. Our wind power in the north of Burgenland, as we had bioenergy and biomass on the topic of the project MIB, but also in the north, meanwhile, a lot of different plants are installed, but not in the field of biomass, as wind is the main resource. As we already have heard before, the methodology foresees also to use GIS mapping, and we therefore have tried to set up our own system, a freeware system, which is available in the net, and which should be used in our point of view, as a kind of planning tool, or can be used, especially quite interesting for decision makers, for stakeholders, to give them an overview about the potentials, the energy demand, or still existing plants. As you can see here, different examples on community level, and to identify also different priority areas for new bioenergy chains. Coming now to the biomass potential and the overview. So we have tried to assess especially five different sectors. So the one of the agriculture, the forestry, the civil sector, livestock waste, as well as co-products from industries. In our project regions, we only have potentials in the field of agriculture as well as forestry. So we have a lot of current competing uses. As you can see here in this table, we have losses, and at the end we have a power potential in the field of agriculture, in the field of forestry. So it is not enough to calculate only with theoretical potential, but to respect also current competing uses as well as other things, and you can only calculate with a restricted amount and not with the overall areas with the overall areas which are available theoretically. Regarding the energy demand, we have used an Excel tool also developed within Make It Be, and especially in this field it's quite interesting that the area of transport is one of the main areas we have to substitute during our during the next years to reach the different goals, and this is also very difficult for us, as we have seen that we can fulfill maybe the goals for the sector of heat. We also can fulfill the sector of electricity, but it will be a problem in the sector of transport. Due to this reason, we have tried to focus about 3 or 4 years ago on the second generation fuels, which means that we see only here the potential for also different decentralized production of different fuels, and only if we can manage and promote new technologies in the field of second generation fuels, we will also be able to fulfill different goals in the sector of transport. Here again, the overall energy demand. So we have about 9,000 gigawatt hours energy demand in Burgenland. As you can see, we still have a lot of liquid fuels. So that means oil or using a lot of oil, but biomass is on second position, so we still use a lot of biomass in our region and want to try to foster this use of biomass for sure within the next years and within the next projects and initiatives. At the end of the regional activities, we had to produce a kind of bioenergy agenda. As I already told, it is a kind of action plan, a kind of strategy, and we are focusing in our region especially on the area of fuel. So we want to try to establish care fuel, we want to establish biogas stations as kind of fuel, as well as local biogas grids. So this is a main focus and a main aspect within our agenda. We have already started with different actions on this and trying to go on within the next months on this matter. But this will be a really very important aspect for us, as well as the feedstock association. So we have seen that there are potentials in the field of forestry, there are potentials in the field of agriculture, but we will get problems in the future if we don't try to identify new and different feedstocks for the production of energy. So we see it in our region. We have a lot of forests in our region, but we are not able to mobilize those potentials, and therefore we have to think about new options. We have to think about new organization structures, and we want to establish a feedstock association with the communities, and manage it maybe on the same way as the water systems, the treatment or the sewage water systems, as well as other still established organization forms, and therefore the feedstock association is also planned in the field of energy. Also, model regions are on the topic of our agenda. So we already have established one model region. Model region for us is more or less defined territory with a kind of energy manager, with a kind of manager who is trying to implement different steps of bioenergy chains. So it is not enough to have the stakeholders involved, but to have one manager who is going to manage different things, different aspects of bioenergy chains, and who is responsible for the implementation of different projects. And therefore, already one region, the Ecoenergy Land, has been established, and we also want to try to establish two other regions. Satellite power units in connection with biogas plants also on the agenda, as well as one very important project for us, the multi-fuel plant. It's a kind of a gasification process based on the still existing plant in Güssing, where we want to test different fractions of waste, and maybe also have the opportunity in the future to produce energy with a new technology, and produce not only heat and electricity with a high efficiency, but also maybe second generation fuels out of it. At the end, only a short overview. This is also the agenda, what I've been speaking before, so trying to set up different goals in different fields. So we have the field of heat, the field of electricity, as well as the field of transport of fuels, and more or less we want to try to reach within the region the self-sufficiency until the year 2020. We will see if it will be possible or not, but we have set up the first projects, the first initiatives, and we hope that we will reach these goals. But as you can see, the area of transport, the area of fuels, is one of the most difficult, and therefore we have to push this sector a lot. So thanks for your attention. This was my presentation to the results of our project Region Austria, and I would like to hand over now to the region in Scotland. Thank you.
Thank you. My name is Chris Perkins. I work for an organization called Highland Birchwoods. And the region for MIB that we've been working in is Highland region. You can see it there on the map, the blue area at the top of Scotland. Now, we've had a very different experience to Goosing. And I think at this point I'd like to say what pleasure it's been to work with the MIB people and some very talented people, and to say just how much the two presentations we've just seen, how important they have been in the development of integrated bioenergy management in the Highlands. Because really before MIB there was no understanding at all of integrated bioenergy management. Highland is a single authority. You can see it there. It's about 220 kilometres by 200 kilometres, and I believe it is larger than Belgium. I've never checked this, but I've heard that it is larger than Belgium. Has one local authority, no mayors at all. So this has made it a very different prospect to work with to Goosing. And we started out this process. Really what I want to get across to you is the idea of what a difference MIB has made to Highland and how it can be applied to other regions. I think Highland might be a bit special in that there are not very many areas outside Britain where you don't have a mayor for an area this size. But, okay, so we started with the key stakeholders interviews. Because before we brought the Renewable Biomass Partnership together, it's very important to know what their issues were, what understandings they wanted. As you can see, we've got a very low population density, and if you look, most of the population is situated in the corner up here, Inverness. So the actual population density, once you get outside Inverness, is about 4 per square kilometre. Okay. Not terribly advanced in terms of heating plants. We've got 56 plants, registered plants, somewhere between 30 and 120 kilowatt power. No record of wood used. But bizarrely, we have a very high turnover of biomass energy from two industrial plants. I'll show you the locations of those in a minute, which use, for bioenergy purposes, about 40% of our wood fuel. Now that might sound perfect. As I go on, I think maybe you'll get an understanding that that is actually stunting the growth of energy independence within the Highlands. Not that it's a bad thing, but it does make life a little more difficult sometimes. And one of the things the RBP was really concerned about was displacement. So if you look at that map, you can see two circles. And the further out you go from there, the happier the RBP, who are made up of the forest industry, political leaders, conservation people, biomass industry people, the further out you go from those two main centres, the happier the RBP is, because we are not displacing material from other regions. So the tools that have been developed are very, very useful. I think the important point, if you're to develop a renewable biomass partnership or to try to replicate the MIB process, is once you have the tools, you can show your decision makers things they didn't know before. They will always come back to you and they will ask for finer and finer refinements. The tools can always do that. So, really I want to get you to the point, I don't want to go over material that's already been covered, of where we've gone from, which was the biomass plants I showed you before, to where we're heading to. And using the toolkit, we managed to map quite a lot, well, we managed to map the heat demand in the Highlands. So, moving towards using the tools as planning tools for our decision makers, and come up with this map here, which shows the balance between, these areas of parishes, the balance between energy use and the potential energy supply from the forests in the area. So again, the application of the toolkits. To the point where we've gone from no integrated planning at all and some suspicion from the forest industry, certainly some suspicion from the decision makers about whether this could be carried out across Highland, to reaching a point where we have agreement on the development of three local sub-regional supply chains. These will be developed. We have got funding to do that, and that funding has come off of the back of the information that we can supply to funders from the MIB methodology. So that's worked very well. The main biomass that we're looking at is forest biomass for reasons I could give you a geography lesson on the highlands, but there really are no other viable sources, either for political reasons with refuse, with waste, industrial or household waste, or because the way that we farm in the highlands makes it very difficult to collect biomass from livestock for farming. So in terms of agriculture, although there are 5 sheep per person in the highlands, they're also scattered over 200,000 hectares, and collecting waste from the sheep really isn't a practical proposition. In terms of forestry, we've stuck to the commercial forestry that's available, 1,080,000 tons. Of that, it does look as though there is a technical potential of 472,000 tons. Unfortunately, as I was saying earlier, this already goes into biomass plants. It's used in 2 specific plants, and very little of that energy returns back into the highlands. In terms of the civil sector, there are regulations, there are also, there is reluctance to see waste incinerators in the highlands. There are also technical issues. That means although we do have civil waste, although we have civil waste, it is very difficult to reach that energy potential there. And as I've already said, livestock is not possible because it's such an extensive farming system. So I'll go rush in here. What we're really looking at is, rather than in Goosing where they can look at all forms of heat, we're looking at energy. We're just really looking at heat in the highlands. One of the other small problems we have is that figure for electricity there. The highlands has a much higher potential for generating electricity than it does heat from biomass. A lot of that is gravity-fed electricity and wind, and also development of wave and tidal power. And I think we have, I can't remember what it is, 20% of Europe's potential energy from waves and tide. So there's not necessarily great emphasis for the development of biomass energy. And as for the future, really the 3 green sites that I showed you on the map, they will become pilot sites for working on local supply chains, and hopefully they'll be replicated. The RBP idea will be carried forward. We'll also work with the university to expand the amount of research that goes into biomass. Okay, thank you. I'm very sorry, it was a bit rushed.
So I have to announce myself. I'm Yuri Begush from Slovenia Forest Service, and I will give you some numbers, some examples, what we are doing through this MIB project. At first, I would like to emphasize some data about Slovenia. It's a small country, one of the smallest in Europe. I will not read all this data. I will just emphasize the last row. Excuse me, just a moment. It doesn't work. Where forests are written here. In Slovenia is covered 58, almost 60% by forests. So forest, we are forested land, one third place in Europe, and the growing stock of forest is 272 cubic meters in 5 years average, and now we estimate that a growing stock is now more than 300 cubic meters per hectare, which is quite high in comparison with other countries in Europe. So when we were talking about biomass mass later through my presentation, we will talk about mainly about forestry, because this is the only, or not the only one, but the most important source of forestry biomass in my country. And also cogeneration plants and biogas plants. But I would, what are missing on this slide is the consumption of private sector of households. We also collected these households and calculated households consumption, which is normal energy from centuries. Recently, households consume more than a million cubic meters. But how they are consumed, this is another question. They are not efficiently consumed, so this is the question we have to, in other projects or through our activities, to improve. Through this project, we try to get in this partnership or network. At first, we had to find some, as my previous speakers told already, to find out the potentials we have. Because if you have potentials, then you also can talk to others what is important and what are possibilities. When we are talking about, and here is the slides of the forestry potentials, I have to emphasize that there are not all the forestry biomass. This is only biomass which is available, which is, they are not good trunks, they are not good wood, they are only wood which is good for wood processing industry, for pulp wood and for biomass. And where darker areas are, the more these biomass, only biomass potentials are. And this is allowable cut, which is normally higher than actual cut we have in Slovenia. I can say that in this moment we can improve our biomass potential from the forests million cubic meters or even more, because the people, they don't want to cut, and the question of mobilization of wood resources in Slovenia is the same as in Austria and other countries in Europe. By our estimation, we have in Slovenia in this moment 2 million dry tone woody biomass out of the forest. We also have data about biomass from non-forest land, from sawmill residues, from biomass, agriculture biomass potential. I have to say that this data we got from Energy's project. It's no need that we discover something if there is already find out. So we use this data from them, and also some biomass potential from treated organic waste by municipalities. With this data, we were invited into a commission or one group for biomass strategy at the Ministry of Agriculture, Forestry and Food. I have to say that Slovenia is a small country. We don't have regions. We have country itself and then municipalities. And we decided that our regional biomass partnership, or we have two levels, one on the state level, and this is, we jump with the Make It Be project in this commission for biomass strategy, and another level are municipality. We will be talking about them later. We serve municipalities somehow with data and with the strategy which was already designed at the ministry, and it will be adopted, I hope, soon also on the national level. We cooperate in this, Slovenia Forest Service and other stakeholders cooperate in this process, and also we serve them with the Make It Be results, and we also presented them project and biomass potentials in Slovenia.